Hello everyone, Gabriel Nassif for ChannelFireball.com, and today I'm going to be playing Blue-White Control, the deck I'm extremely likely to be playing in the Mythic Championship in a few days. I'm recording this video on the Monday before the Mythic Championship, leaving for London tomorrow. I'm going to try and get some draft practice in while I'm there, and I'm pretty much set on Blue-White. And very, very close to final list. So by the time you see this video, hopefully I'll have done extremely well with this deck. I think it's very good. I don't know if it's the best deck in the format, but I know it extremely well, and I think I can play it well, even if I don't always play it great on my stream. But yeah, I'm gonna go through the deck lists, give you some few explanations, I guess, and then I'll move on to a league. So we have 24 lands. I usually play 25. I'm down to 24 because I'm playing the full 4-up, and it's a bit new for elimination. Trying that out. I think the card's really good. I don't know if I want to go all the way up to 4. But yeah, so one less land. I'm only playing 2 colonnades. Not sure Colonnade is that great right now. You don't especially need it, or not a ton of it, and having your lands come into play untapped is a pretty big deal in a format that's pretty fast. So I've been trying to cut down on Colonnade and haven't really missed them too much. I have 4 Field of Ruin. I think that card is a no-brainer. It's one of the reasons Blue-White Control became so good. That and the comeback of Jade's Divine Sculpture. Then I've got 4 Flooded Strand, a couple Hallowed Fountains, a couple Glacial Fortress, some basics, and an extra Polluted Delta, just as it's a tiny bit of mana fixing, lets you get dual land, and it's an extra card to delve for Logic Knots. Spot removal, I'm playing 4 Path to Exile and 1 Condemn. Some people like Oust, some people like Condemn, some people play 6 spot removal, play 1 of each. I like Condemn a bit better. It's better against Blue-Red Phoenix, which is a tough matchup. Oust is really nice against cards like Dark Confident and Noble Hierarch turn 1 and Young Pyromancer, but for now I'm on Condemn. 1 Spell Snare, just pretty solid card, especially with only 2 colonnades in the deck, means you get to cast it on turn 1 a bit more often. One of my least favorite cards in the deck, but it's decent, it keeps value even late in the game sometimes. And it's nice to have a bunch of different targets with Snapcaster Mage. I've got the 1 main deck Surgical Extraction. Card's pretty strong in the format right now. It's pretty much your only good card against Dredge game 1. It helps you get rid of Tron if you can feel a ruin on other Tron lands and extract it. That's a really strong play. Same against Valakut. And yeah, it does feel like it's decent utility. It's decent in the mirror match. You want to go after a card like Cryptic Command or a Counterspell or a Win Condition. Another controversial card, Wall of Omens. I'm playing 2 right now. I think at the Mythic Championship, I could see myself playing 0, 1, or 2. My teammates don't like it too much. I really like it, so we'll see if it does work for me today. Especially shines against humans, buys you a lot of time. Also shines against some of the white Eldrazi deck that are becoming a bit more popular. Just blocking Thalia's early in the game buys you a lot of time. Free Snapcaster Mage, pretty stock. 1 negate, 2 Logic Knot, nothing too crazy. 4 eliminations, I've talked about it. Cycles for 1. It plays nicely around cards like Thalia, because you can cycle it for 1 mana, even if they have the 2-1 in play. It plays nicely against Chalice of the Void. That's another card that's a bit more popular than it used to be. So yeah, you just cycle it when you need lands in the early turn or need to cycle, and then later in the game it's a nice little 2-for-1. It's really nice in the control matchups. You have a bunch of inspirations, just make sure you hit land drops, etc. So trying out 4 for now, we'll see how that goes. 1 Vidalia Click. This card's kind of, it's the best card in the mirror match, especially after sideboard when people have less removal. It's just overall solid. It really shines against Tron as well, or any big mana deck. It's another blocker against humans. It's actually very serviceable against humans. Trades with Manthus Rider. So pretty solid card right now. One Detention Sphere. Another good card, but that you don't want too many of. It can be clunky, but I think you need to play at least one. Some people play two. You need it against decks like the Artifact decks, the Weird Prison deck. It's nice removal for Meddling Mage. you know, after sideboard, you're happy to have it against cards like Gaddock Teague. It's good against decent against Phoenix. It's one of the ways you can beat Dredge Game 1 if they get multiple Blood Gas or Amalgam into play, like three or more at one point, and you get them all. It can be a way to win the game, so just good card. And then we've got free Cryptic Command, pretty stuck. Two Jace. I decided to cut a Jace because I have four Elimination, so something had to go. So just think Jace reasonable cut. And then the Sweepers. I'm playing a mix. One Verdict, one Wrath, one Settle, one Terminus. I really dislike Settle right now, but I want to give it a try one last time. Just so clunky, just so much worse than Verdict almost always, but it is one of your only outs against Dredge as well, like the one Surgical, the one Settle, and then give you outs, and it might be good in a world of open decklists where people know I have one in my deck. It might make the misplay. I'm not too sure about that, if it plays in my favor or not. But I'll give it a try. And finally, a couple Teferi. I was not super high on that card originally, but I've been really liking it. I think 2-2 is good. Onto the sideboard. I have a couple Purge. Just gets rid of Blood Moon, Dark Confident, Liana of the Veil, Death Shadow. Really strong card, bringing it against Burn, bringing it against humans. Couple Rest in Peace. I might play a third one at the Mythic Championship. There's a couple cards I wanted to try out today. Some only have two, but obviously it's the nuts against Dredge. Dredge just weird deck. You have to respect it or else you just lose. Not that many decks have naturally good Dredge matchups, so yeah. Also really good against Phoenix, Pyromancer Ascensions, their scariest card, and Rest in Peace deals for that forever. One Stony Silence. I like the card. I wish I could play a second one. Tiny Reinforcement. Very strong against Burn. You bring it against humans and Dredge. Lots of these cards I wish I could play a second one. I wish I could have a 25 card sideboard, but that's not how it works. One Gear Hulk. That's the card I get the most questions about. So the theory is that it plays around cards like Gaddock Teague, Meddling Mage, Thalia, all these annoying cards. It's also good against the artifact decks after sideboard and a few other matchups. But yeah, it's basically a sweeper that plays around the sweeper hates. And it's been good. Sometimes it's worse than an angel, but I've definitely had a few spots where if the Gear Hulk I drew was either a sweeper or an angel, I would have lost, but I won because it was exactly Gear Hulk. Lyra, just really good against the creature matchups. Just some people have started cutting the angels. I still think they're really, really strong and just win you the game. Pretty swingy card. Sometimes they're going to be clunky, but they're going to win you the game a lot. Damping Sphere, not a card I have played with a lot, but it's really good against Amulet Titan. It's definitely helps against Tron, and there's a few combo decks out there like Cheerios or Ad Nauseam. That card's also the nuts. Storm as well. Second Surgical Extraction, more hate for Dredge. Actually a card I bring in the control matchups. I used to think these cards were kind of bad in control matchups, but the way they play out, they're pretty serviceable. Also bringing against Tron, even though I'm not sure the second copy is good because they can counter it with their Relic of Progenitus. If they have a Relic out and they keep it on tap, they can just Relic themselves and it makes the Surgical fizzle. Geist of Saint Traff, that's a card I'm trying out today. Maybe I'll even try and add a second just to get a better feel. Shaheen Serrani, who I test with, has been pretty high on it, so I'm going to give it a try. And then second click, combo, Tron. Just control, just really strong in some matchups. Second negate, an extra disdainful stroke for big mana decks and a dispel, also control matchups. So yeah, basically all these cards, if you have a good read on your meta, you can make an argument for playing more copies. Literally, I think every last one of them, whether it's Dispel, Disdainful Stroke, Negate, maybe not a third click, maybe not a third Surgical, but you know, second Damping Sphere if your meta is full of combo, another Baneslayer, even a second Gear Hulk, second Timely if Burn is all over the place, more Stony, more Rest in Peace, more, all these cards are really good. So yeah. That's it for the deck. All right, round one. And Gnorl Grande, I believe this is Andrea Mengucci. Let's see if I get some revenge on the man who knocked me out of the Mythic Invitational. Not exactly the same stakes, but you know, we'll see. All right, I have to keep this. I feel like at the Mystic Championship, this hand would be really good because I would get rid of the card I don't need. I have no clue what Andrea is playing in this format. I could see him be on Blue Red Phoenix. And that's going to get rid of Cryptic Command. I know I played against Javier Dominguez a few days ago in the match. I was playing Phoenix. I could see him being on Humans. So much pressure. I guess the stakes are pretty high. The fact that I have basic planes in my opening hand makes Cryptic Command slightly worse, I guess, slightly harder to cast on turn 4. Apparently Andrea is 3-1, and if he goes 4-1 in this league, he's locking it up for the PT. So that's such a goofball. Ooh, Amulet Titan. Or is it a Weir Prison? Jeez. Can I have my Cryptic Command back? Your eyes full of surprise. Never where you expect him. Don't let that resolve. I'm going to save Negate for a spell that actually does something. So it looks like he's playing the Weir Prison deck. There is a Chalice. I'm not sure. I think I'm supposed to probably Surgical Negates. Pab do nothing. I could also just yeah, I'm not too sure. I could Surgical Ancient Sterns, but obviously Andrea doesn't have a second one. He's gonna play Chalice for one. I think I'm gonna let it resolve. So it means that Ancient Sterns not gonna do anything anymore. This is kind of a weird spot. Right, I guess I'll just say go. Do have four opts. I do have that Surgical. I think I'm just gonna use a negate. Four up might not seem like much, but I'm assuming Andrea only has Ancient Stirrings as his one mana card. I think that's the only one mana card they play. The one Spellbomb and four Stirrings. Battle Cloister. Alright, I might have to play my Snap here. I guess I'll just Surgical a bunch of cards. I get to see his hand too. He has another one that is good value. Witchbane Orb, Mox Opal, 4 Ancient Starings, 1 Crucible, 1 Death. So pretty stuck. Does he have any blue white control tech, 2 Spyglass? Can he kill me if I remove Spellbomb? Oh yeah, he can kill me with Ipnir Rivulet. Tolaroes, Mox Opal, Witchbane Orb. Okay, so his hand's pretty bad. So he doesn't even care that much if I get rid of it, but obviously I should, because two cards a turn is a lot. Yeah, so... Is he scooping? My hand's really bad. But the matchup's kind of bad to start with, so... If he knew my hand, he might not scoop. This is kind of what I'm talking about. Like, if I knew what matchup I was playing, if I had a Cryptic Command instead of Settle in my hand, I'd be in such good shape. So I think they have Zai after sideboard and Tezzeret, so I need to be mindful of that. Gonna definitely bring in Negate and Disdainful Stroke. Stony Silence doesn't do a ton, but I think it just does just enough. Purge might actually be reasonable. Gear Hulk is good. Lyra might be good. Sweepers are pretty bad. I could keep in one Verdict. Okay, Zai gets out of control. Wall of Omens is pretty bad. There's some matchups where Wall, quote unquote, doesn't do anything, but I still keep them in when I keep 4 path. This way I have the option of pathing my own wall and ramping. But I don't think this is one of these matchups. I think keeping in 2 path, 1 Verdict is reasonable. It kind of sucks to keep in Verdict when I have Clicks and Geist and Snap, but definitely Zai kind of owns me, even though they don't play as many artifacts. They don't have like all the artifacts that cantrip, so not like Zai is insane against me. Maybe it was the Gear Hulk I don't need to, but they also bring in Torpor Orb, which shuts down Gear Hulk. Lyra's kind of a nice, like kind of a Tezzeret answer, I guess, but I think they keep in a lot of bridges, so I guess I'm not gonna bring in Lyra. And is Surgical, maybe Surgical is just not that great against them. Like it's nice, but it's not like, it's not part of your game plan. You don't need it. And it's really bad against Chalice for one. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe one more path, maybe a wall. I'll do a wall. If I knew his exact sideboard, maybe I could bring in a second purge, stuff like that. But we're not gonna have access to the numbers. The way it's gonna work, we play the first round of Modern in the dark, meaning we don't know what our opponent's playing, and after that, we get to see our opponent's deck list, which contains their hand really doesn't do much. But it's a matchup where you don't necessarily need a hand to do something, and I have so many good cards I can draw. I'm just gonna keep, but I'm not sure this is great keep. I can even just run a Snapcaster out there. It's not the worst. Some early pressure. So yeah, so we get deck list, so we get the full main deck, the full detailed main deck, and then for the sideboard we get to see which cards they play, but not how many of each cards they play. Spellskites. That's another reason to keep Verdict in. Maybe I should keep a Wrath of God too, I'll see. Alright, well I'm not gonna play Snapcaster because they have a blocker anyways. If they didn't have a blocker for Snapcaster, I might play it, but since they already have Spellkite, I'm not going to do that. Tectonic Edge is kind of scary. One of the ways... Oh, I guess I have 8 cards in hand. I guess I should have played Snapcaster Mage. Oh well. That's kind of a mistake. One of the ways they beat you is Crucible plus Tectonic Edge. I think game one, that's maybe their best shot at victory. Really, I should just let Andrea win. This way I have one more player in the tournament against whom I have a good matchup. This is really, this Weird Prisons deck's really good, but has a really, really crappy blue-white control matchup. But this is, like, this deck is, this Weird Prison deck's arguably, you know, it's one of these decks that could claim the title of best deck in Modern. Ooh, the land. Nice. Larless, probably. I mean, Chalice is not as good as her sideboard. Alright, he's still got Chalice. Chalice for one, sure. Hey. Well, it looks. He doesn't have much, so I'm gonna use the click on myself. He actually can sack fair and he has a mana, or was he one short? Sack fair and play Crucible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He was one short. Oh, click has no come into play. I'm such an idiot. Alright. I'll let Chalice for one, paying off big time. We could just bring back Boggle Cloister here. Or in Indra's case, that's what he's gonna do. Makes sense. Yeah, if I just played my 2 Snapcaster Mage, he'd probably be, what are we, turn 7? He'd be at like 16 or 14, something like that. Definitely regretting it now. You drawing 2 cards a turn. More 1 drops. Alright, I think I'm gonna lose this game. Kept a pretty sketchy hand. Yeah, I'll keep in, what does that even do? I don't know, maybe I have a blocker. I'll keep in two sweepers and maybe just board out all the paths. Jeez. The funny part is that I might be, if I draw land number 4, I might just be able to win just by going like counter your bridge, bounce your bridge, kill you with the click. So I made in hindsight, I made a lot of mistakes this game. I'm mostly not playing Snapcaster Mages when I could. But this is the spot I was talking about, was opt against Chalice. Whereas Elimination just plays around it. We are 4-4. You got just bridge, but he's trying to trick me. And I can't really bounce it. Alright, because Gray has two spells. I guess if I bounce the Spellskite, he can't recast them. So I've got that going for me. We'll see. So you can Tectonic Edge and then play Crucible of Worlds. It's pretty bad for me. I don't think I have a counterplay. Maybe you go for Field of Ruins if you're in draw, because I can actually get to a spot where maybe I have like just all basics in play. When did he replay Inventor's Fair? I'll play it out, but this game looks pretty lost. Good news is, he's probably drawing a bunch of dead cards. These Chalices. I'm not sure that Chalice for 2 made a ton of sense from his part. I wonder if he's thinking the same thing right now. Wow, Zai's really good. Now he gets to sag the artifacts he doesn't want. Like, might even sag the Chaos for 2. Alright, I'm just gonna concede. I think that's good. Jester Cap. Surgical on Wary of Extraction is nice, but it's just so bad against Chalice for 1. I think this is pretty reasonable. Kind of weird to have all these creatures and the sweepers. I wish I had a better solution. I think I'll be okay. I just need to have a reasonable draw. My hand was obviously a bit sketch. Alright, this is a bit better. That's funny. sure there's anything I really want to counter on turn two, but A, you never know, and B, it's actually worth taking the two damage because I could join to an odd or another elimination, which I'd want to cast right away. This is kind of a close one. I get to see my hand, which is a bit annoying, but I don't care about it too much. I think I just want to hit my land drops. I think I can deal with Spyglass later, honestly. I'm going to cycle in response in case I draw Teferi. Or, other way around, in case I draw Spell Snare. Sometimes they just name Field of Rune too, right? You can name Field of Rune as that card. Not this matchup though, Jace. Makes sense. I like naming Jace there because it's just one mana cheaper than Teferi, and you usually have more Jace than Teferi. Oh, you know what he should have done is probably play Bubble first, right? You play Bubble first in case the top card is Teferi or Jace. Maybe he targeted himself. Maybe there was like some synergy where you target yourself. Spell Skies, sure. That's a good spot for us. He's down to three cards in hand and I have three counter spells plus a snap plus an opt. Yeah, basically I'm gonna let that resolve, let all these cards resolve, and I'm just gonna wait for a Gear Hulk or a Detention Sphere. I don't know, maybe I'm making a mistake. They do have, he does have Spellskite for my Detention Sphere. But I think I'm gonna be okay. I need to worry a bit about Twir. Chalice for two. So I think I just want to use Cryptic Command here. Just counter draw, get the value. I think that might be a mistake by Andrea. I think maybe he's supposed to keep... The game's a tiny bit awkward for me if he just keeps his mana up there, because I'm not sure I want to tap out for a snap. If he does, because if he gets something good with Weir, I might actually be in trouble. I'm gonna wait a bit on the verdict. Alright. He's had enough. Kind of a couple premature scoops, but it's 2.5 days before deck lists are due. Sounds like he might be not super excited about his deck and just he's being time efficient. All right, maybe I shouldn't have the chat. I don't know. Or at least let him know I'm recording. Anyways, well, we're prison, favorable matchup, but they can definitely win games, almost, honestly, steal games if they have the right draw and they play tight. But yeah, I guess if you're the we're prison side, maybe try and make it as scary and awkward as possible for your opponent and try not tap out when you have a no-tap counter spells, but try and set up turns where you can maybe, I don't know, it's tough. You don't have that many impactful cards. Anyways, let's see if we can keep going. All right, back for round two, and I'm on the draw. I'm starting with seven cards. I have no cheap cards. I have my one Terminus in my opening hand, so I think I'm gonna mulligan. I forget who Jesse Samick is. Maybe that's their actual name. I know they play a decent bit of Modo and play well. Sorry, I kind of feel bad for not remembering now. This is kind of a tricky spot. This is another spot where open decklist would be great. I know if that negate does. I think it's between negate and island. I kind of want to keep all my lands. I have a cantrip. I can path my wall. What do they play? Negate could potentially maybe be my best card. All right, I'm going to get rid of island. That's funny. Could be best card, could be worst card. Looks like Brix's Shadow. Turn one Delta is usually Brix's Shadow. End of turn, Thought Scour. Definitely glad I got rid of land. If they're Grixis Shadow, this is a matchup where, this is one of the matchups where getting, you get punished the most for getting flooded. I'm not saying getting flooded like draw all lands, but like games can come down to exactly who draws the extra lands or that kind of stuff. All right, keeping mana up is okay. They have like Thoughtseize or something. I'm just gonna run the wall out there. Keeping the gate up is definitely reasonable. Countering an Inquisition or Thoughtseize to protect my path to exile can be good. Through the one Terminus. This is a matchup where you want Verdict the most. This is the best matchup for Supreme Verdict. Surgical draw is kind of awkward. They already drew their two basics that can be really good for me if the game goes for a little while, goes on for a little while. Would have been nice to draw the Stubborn, the Surgical before Stubborn. You know what? I'm going to play it on their turn because they're just so unlikely to have two Stubborn Denials. And I just want to make them tap the mana on their turn. I'm not sure it makes a big difference. This is going to be awkward if they have two Stubborn Denials. But the odds are so slim. On the other hand, them having one less mana doesn't matter much because Alright, so that was the spot I was talking about that could be really good for me. It's probably like frowning right now. Just drawing two basics in this matchup's like your worst nightmare. A Jace might be annoying, we'll see. I haven't had too much trouble dealing with JVP. It seems like it should be really good against control, but it's a bit clunky, I wanna say. Should I counter that just to slow down Jace? They're gonna have three cards, four cards, I can surgical, Sovereign Denial. I wanna just try and surgical the first spell, the flashback though. I think that'd be a better use of my surgical. Yeah, it's a bit slow, like you get minus two, the plus doesn't do anything against me, obviously. Targeting Thoughtseize, I can surgical it. Also, no Orthotes in their deck is good news. Hopefully you have one in hand somehow. That'd be the dream. Angler, Death Shadow, Snap, Oscar. So they have a pretty stacked hand. And their version, 2 Battle Rage, 1 Culligan's Command, 3 Snap. Pretty standard. Second Dismember. So what did we say? I already forgot. Death Shadow, Angler, Snap, and I already forgot the last card. Very nice. What was their last freaking card? I think it was Thoughtscar, right? Not too sure opting on my turn was huge. Maybe if I find detention sphere, I can sphere Jace. Alright, I'm in obviously a really good spot here. Oh, they can't even play F Shadow. Not that it matters. This game's fairly over. My Jace is just a tiny bit better. This is another decent matchup for blue-white. It depends on blue-white's version a bit. But it's always been blue-white favored. The more verdicts, the better. Sideboard gets a bit scarier when they have their own planeswalker, but it's still pretty good. You get purge and stuff. Oh, they mail me because, yeah, Terminus on top. Alright, I mean, they're literally 0% to win this game. Even more so now that I have Teferi. They're probably going to scoop when I play the Teferi, actually. I'd be surprised. So, I usually don't bring in Rest in Peace, especially on the draw. I bring in one on the play for the quick Gormag. I do bring in Dispel. Dispel's about the only counter spell I really like in this matchup. The others can be okay. I think Lyra is good enough. Geist might be good in this matchup, right? Negate is serviceable. Timely, usually don't gain the life, so it makes it less appealing. Click is okay. And yeah, I could do one Rest in Peace. Let's see, that's 61. I definitely want all these cards. I definitely want all these cards. I definitely want all these cards. Settle is serviceable, but pretty mediocre. I think Terminus is probably a tiny bit better. It's close, though. I think this is definitely a solid way of sideboarding. They do have JVP, they only had one though. They have Liliana the Last Hope in their sideboard. How many cards do they have that rely on graveyard? Probably Snapcaster is really good against them. Really, really good against them, like extremely good. So, I don't know, I think one Rest in Peace should be in the deck still. I'll talk a bit, tiny bit more about Rest in Peace in a second. Maybe Geist is bad, they have blockers for it, but you can kill them really fast. You also have Liliana of the Veil sometimes. I'll try it for science, as we say. Boarding out a land on the draw if you have 25 is pretty reasonable in this matchup too. I don't like it so much when I only already have 24. Cryptic is a bit clunky, actually. I'll board out a Cryptic. So yeah, so the thing about Rest in Peace, it's really weird, because when they Inquisition you on turn one and you have it in your opening hand, they're almost always going to take it, because the card is really good against them if you have it on turn two. The problem is, if you look at the deck, it's one of the only dead draws in the late game. And the way this matchup works, you're in top deck mode a lot. So it's the kind of card that, if they care about it, they're going to either take it with a discard spell or maybe counter it with Stubborn Denial, you know, if they have one mana up and you play it on turn two. And obviously you don't want to hold it too long, because one of the points of Rest in Peace is disabling Gormag Angler. So yeah, even on the draw, I usually don't bring it in. I'm going to bring it in this time, but because of that scenario where they can just cast turn two Angler and then your turn two is a Rest in Peace, and they're like, okay, sure. So drawing two lands first two turns of the games, this is kind of a disaster in this matchup. We'll see if I can recover. We need them to flood out, basically. Also, one thing to pay attention is to notice if they ever mail their basic land. It might influence some of your plays later in the game. Obviously, the dream was game one. Them drawing their both their basics, or, you know, they mail their basics, all that stuff, that's really good for you. Inquisition. Another of my favorite things in Modern, when they have Inquisition and you have no cards that cost fear or less. We almost dodged it. By almost, I mean not really. The difference between 1 and 0 and probability is probably just super huge. They already drew one basic. Would it fetched for a basic? No. I guess maybe they're just protecting their red source. And they only have two Watery Graves. I don't know which lands they play exactly. I think they have five dual lands and two basics. The rest is fetch. Oh, because they already mailed the Blood Crypt. So if they... they might just have one Steam Vent, one Blood Crypt. They probably have a few red cards in their deck. Alright, I'm in a pretty bad spot here. They're just gonna sculpt. They're just gonna have such a strong hand. Finally drew a card that does something, so that's nice. But they're pretty far ahead, I think. Sometimes they're not as far ahead as you think they are, because none of their cards don't line up very well. But yeah, I mean, they have a creature, a planeswalker, and as many cards in hand as I do. This is one of the matchups where you miss Colonnade the most. Maybe D matchup, or especially after sideboard where they can't just keep in Fatal Push. Well, they knew about the verdict, but... The click, interesting. I did not expect them to take click. Kind of surprised. I mean, it's decent against Liliana. So they're repping, Disdainful Stroke, which they usually have after sideboard. So I'm just gonna go ahead and say go. Do I take Teferi if they didn't have a Disdainful Stroke there? They got back a Death Shadow, yes they did. Okay, does Feel of Rain do anything for me? Sometimes they keep in Battle Rage after sideboard. To draw Dispel here, or two, and I don't have two mana counter spells anymore. Dispel or perhaps Exile would be two really good draws. Wow, they're actually countering that? That's so aggro. That's really, really weird. I'm gonna cast it now, just because I might need the mana on my turn. Okay, do they have like triple Stubborn Denial? I mean, I guess so. They're at four. I mean, can they beat a Geist? They might just not be able to beat a Geist. That's funny. I think they just have another Stubborn Denial in hand. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play Geist first. Probably shaking their head if they don't have Liliana. I'm gonna get rid of their red source in case they have Team or Battle Rage. I feel like they should. Seems like the card you would board out against a control deck, but I've definitely had people cast Battle Rage against me after sideboard. They have Basic Mountain. Wow. Well, I guess we're gonna find out if they have Battle Rage. I mean, they know my last card in hand. And I ain't blocking. No Battle Rage. Do they have Liliana? Could have Dismember, I guess. Dismember saves them. They have one in the grave. So let's see, if they have Dismember and Stubborn, I'm dead. Because they can, should I attack? I'm trying to figure out if I should attack Liliana or not. Does it make a difference? Oh, that's interesting. They might have Snap. Snap, Dismember the token, block. In which case, I at least get to Teferi minus Death Shadow. Because they're going to have to tap out for it. Question is, I think I should just tag them anyways. I'm guessing they have Snap Dismember, yeah. But that's still okay for us. Because because they have to tap two mana that they obviously can't pay for a life, so they're gonna be tapped out. So I get to they obviously have to block the guys right away. They can't afford to keep a snap back. It's a pretty sick game. That's funny. I think Teferi Minus is the play. Obviously, brainstorming is better than drawing one and untapping two in this spot, but they just get to recast Death Shadow right away. So they're going for the aggressive line, because or else the game's gonna. So if I have a removal spell in my top two cards, I'll probably win. If not, I'll probably lose. But I think they still have a counter spell in hand. If I had played Jason Bounce Death Shadow, I would have been in just as bad of a spot, because they would just have like two Death Shadows in play right now, and I already cast my one verdict. Alright, I'm expecting that card to get countered. Yeah. That's kind of what I was talking about. Like, that's really like a few extra lands if I had the one Colonnade in play. It really comes down to not much, and flooding in this matchup's pretty bad. Liliana the Lasso did a lot of work this game. It usually doesn't do that much work, but they had time to use it multiple times, so it was good for them. I'm gonna stick with the one rest in peace. I didn't take a good look at their graveyard towards the end. The one basic mountain is kind of cool. I've never seen that before, or not in a very long while. I know I said you don't want land heavy hands, but I do have Colonnade and Field of Ruin and perfect mana, so I feel like it kind of makes up for it. They're down to 5. That's obviously really good for me. Smashup is weird. It is blue-white favored, but some games, they just have these draws where you feel like you can't even do anything. So it can be a tiny bit frustrating. But it's pretty hard for them to have the... It's kind of like the fetch land, Thoughtseize, Death Shadow draw, and then second Death Shadow, counter. These kind of draws. So they're going to be pretty happy to see that I don't have much going on. Um, I'll just play Flightstran and use it to fetch a Hollowed Fountain. That's rough. Very rough. So if I get them now, they have Culligan's Command in red. If I get their blue black now, I make them choose between second blue and second black for Liliana. So I think I like that plan. But going after their few, I guess they have basic mountain in their deck, so you're not getting them off red. So yeah. I'll search for planes, make it look like maybe I drew Path to Exile. Yeah, I like doing it now this way. I mean, that's the downside. I give them the extra mana, but this way they have to choose between blue mana for their blue spells or second black for Liliana. If potentially they only have second black. All right, looks like we're gonna lose. I kept land heavy hand and I drew three lands in a row, so, or two lands in a row. Doesn't seem like much, but I don't know. Three lands in a row? I was on the plane, no, two lands only, but still. Anyways, I'm done complaining. That's good for me. Didn't you, right? Or didn't you... Just one card they didn't know about, I think? Alright, kind of same spot here. I can make him choose between red mana and second black. Or I can make them choose between... If I get this, they're just gonna get swamp. But they won't have double blue. If I get this... I think in the long run, it's probably better to get rid of their second blue. That's a really good draw. I'm gonna keep Delta in case I draw Jace. Looting, that's fine. Devalue, discard two fetch lands. We're hoping for counterspell here. Plus they know one of my draws, so there's only one card they don't know about. So that's perfect. I get the value. And yeah, I mean they have to, right? They have to go for it, but I was pretty lucky. An angler? Yikes. Wow. Some pretty good draws. All right. Alright, do I attack with colonnades and give them a live death shadow? Alright, since that's Wrath of God, I'm definitely going to be attacking with colonnade. I might just fetch again. The game might go another 3, 4, 5 turns, having one less land in my deck. Not sure how impactful it is. The one life could matter too. Also want to try and keep one card in hand. I think after sideboard they should have at least 2 Culligan's Commands. Can't remember how many they had in their main deck. But usually they have more Culligan's Command for artifact matchups and stuff. Alright, to fetch or not to fetch? I think if I draw Jace in this spot, I win anyways. I'm just gonna fetch. Probably should have fetched whatever it was 2 turns ago. Snap or Angler, kind of interesting. I think they might go for Snap here. I don't know, it's close. Cause I'm gonna attack Liliana and then they play an Angler and then have a 3 turn clock. Yeah, they just went for Angler, no, I think that makes sense. Alright. I'm just gonna attack Liliana, I think. How many Stubborn Denials gone? Just the one. I think it's possible to have it, so I'm gonna hold on my path. I'll hold on to my path for now. See if I can sequence in an interesting way. I don't think I'm gonna block his wall. I'm gonna try and tab the Angler though. Didn't expect that to resolve. They might have Death Shadow in hand. Jeez. Uh-oh, did I use the wrong card? Oh, that's a good draw. Well, needed some lucky top decks, and I got them. Oh, that was close. Assuming they're drawing dead. Can't imagine how to get out of this one. Alright, GG's. All right, back for round three, and I think I was listening to the audio of the first couple of rounds to make sure everything was okay, and I think there was probably slightly annoying background noise. I'm really sorry about that. I think maybe it was my phone charging that was a bit too close to the mic or running some interference. I think it should be gone. Hopefully it is. I did a few tests and it looks like it was gone. So yeah, sorry about that. Are we on the die roll? We have a pretty solid opening hand. Usually feels pretty good to have spells there. So I'm actually just gonna go ahead and play Delta. A, I get to fetch for Hallowed Fountain, have one less land in my deck, and B, I have spells there anyway, so I get to spells there on turn two. And C, there's a tiny chance opponent is on a Sin Inspired Guide Chalice of the Void deck. That's unfortunate. I'm already down 3 minutes in a matchup where you really don't want to be down time. That's not a good pairing. All right. So blue-white control mirror match is, I like it. It's cool. It's interesting. But it is, time is the most important thing. So that's really not great for us. So what you really want to see in your opening hand in the mirror match is a bunch of ops and Snapcaster Mage. That's the ideal scenario. Illumination everywhere. Does some really good draws. The wall into the land was pretty much perfect, honestly. Drawing basics is, I'm not sure why I got basic planes, by the way, that was just brain fart. Did I actually try and force it to fairy through here? I have Logic Knot and Spell Snare. Meaning they need to have, I'll get rid of the Colonnades first. Get more colored mana, more cards in my grave. I'm gonna get the Hellish Fountain now. Really don't wanna draw it. I think I'm actually just not going to tap out, not going to risk it. I'm just going to, I feel like I have a good grip on the matchup and hopefully I can outplay my opponent later in the game. I don't need to rush anything. All right, they're playing Ops, Serum Visions, and Illumination. You don't want to Snapcaster, tap your own Snapcaster there just to get an extra land. I'm going to save these Snapcasters for good value, counter spells. So the mirror match is really interesting. It's, well, first of all, on Magic Online and to some extent in real life, it's a lot about time, except on Magic Online, it's, you know, if you run out of time, you lose. In real life, what ends up happening a lot is that I'm actually just going to play Jace here just to bait out a counterspell. I don't want to discard a good card. So yeah, game one, a lot of the time, is not really about card advantage. It's more about trading your cards that matter efficiently. Plays kind of weirdly. Another time, whoever ends up winning and whoever has like the most relevant cards. So having that extra Snapcaster or that extra negate, you know, if you're playing a second negate or fourth Snapcaster, can be really huge in the matchup. That card can be pretty annoying too. Like, I could have Cryptic Commanded Relic if I had more mana, but I didn't want to tap down too low. This is really good. This could end up being really good for me. Historically, whoever starts tapping out first in the control mirror match ends up losing. It's not as true as it used to be, but it's still somewhat true. Alright, so they can counter probably twice. Me too. So let's see, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Can go 4-2-2. I think Jace first is better, and then you have Teferi in hand for Teferi minus. It's actually pretty good for me too, I think. It's one less mana. Okay, wow, straight up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Detention Sphere. I think I want to use a Cryptic Command. I can Cryptic and then Logic Knot. I could fetch first too to not draw. Condemn of the... I don't care too much about the Detention Sphere. What I do care about is fighting on their turn though. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and I'll let it resolve for now, I guess. I really don't want to draw that Condemn, but I kind of want to draw that Could be playing Mana Lake, especially if they're playing a bunch of relics. I kind of want to try and play around that as much as possible. But I don't think they're playing it. I'm just going to go ahead and fetch first. This worked out nicely. I feel like we're super far ahead. We'll see. That's a really good draw. A surgical now. Actually, that makes no sense. Do I want to use Snapcaster just to have a snap in play, start beating down, but they probably have a billion path in hands anyways. I'm a surgical now to Teferi. It's like a decent, definitely one of the better surgical targets. So they have path, spell snare, condemn reinforcement, right? So I really don't want to play Snapcaster Mage, actually. They have 2 Jace left, a lot of removal, 2 Cryptics, second Detention Sphere. Yeah, so I mean, I think this game's pretty over. Now it's just about not playing too slow. They might even just scoop there. I guess, nah, they can't scoop just because of the time. It's just too good for them to be in that spot in the mirror match. Can't blame them. Wish I had a couple extra minutes. That's fine. I feel like they should keep their relic. The one card they draw is not gonna make a difference. Should just keep it for future value, I guess. This does nothing. This actually does something, maybe one day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I use data, or I'm just gonna say go. So what's the plan here to kill them as fast as possible? I'm just gonna start plussing Jace on them, I guess. I really like not keep a path there. It's kind of awkward. Kind of panicking. Think I'm gonna be okay. Just let that resolve. Probably gonna take Teferi and I get to play my second one. Maybe I need to stop casting these ops just so I don't get decked. few more turns and we should be good. Discard wall and discard condemn, I guess. I should just discard detentions here, actually. I don't think that card does much for me. My flooded strand? Weird. What is that about? Maybe they misclicked. Must be a misclick. There's no reason not to use the ultimate there. I have a second Teferi there. I can bounce it if I need to. I'll get the emblem. Oh yeah, and I get to just get back my Teferi. Oops. Didn't mean to discard path. Alright, this game is probably gonna take a few more minutes. Not sure I need detention sphere anymore. Should obviously go after the dual lands. Doesn't matter that much. I don't even need to do that. I'm just like anxious, I guess, whatever you want to call it, like fear of something. Like making plays when all I have to do is click F6. Alright, 11 minutes is not a ton, but it is something we can work with. Because sideboard games are much faster, but definitely not ideal. That's the problem. I was 3 minutes behind, and it's kind of funny because what ends up happening in the mirror match is that whoever is ahead game one, it can actually end up costing them in the long run because they win game one, but they were ahead, so they get to use more cards, play more spells, and get more triggers, and then you kind of lose out on time, and then all of a sudden, you know, you're up a game, but you're down like 5, 6, 7 minutes. All right, I want all these cards. I think I want both walls. Stroke, negate, negate. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, and Stony Sounds, actually, against the Relic version. That card's good. I'm not going to leave the Verdict in. I could do another Path to Exile. I think this is good. I could do minus one Surgical. I think Surgical's still pretty strong after sideboard. Surgical's weird. I don't know what happened if I just had a poor understanding of the matchup in the past, but I always felt like that card was not super good in the mirror match. But the way you want to play it is, what I also used to do is I would just throw it on an opt as soon as they win like Snapcaster opt. I'd do, well, that's decent value, you know. But really what you want to do is get one of the cards that matter. Cryptic's one of the better ones. You have Cryptic. You have Turn 2 Tank. What's going on here? Cryptic, Teferi, Jace. All very good. If you can get Snapcaster somehow, that's probably really good too. Seems pretty hard to get a Snapcaster though. To counter it. So always fetch your duels. Yeah, I'll cycle the first one. I have four. Maybe I'll draw an opt. Maybe I'll draw another one. I'd feel much better was a counter spell in hand. Counter is Jace, but basically in this matchup, people never go for it. And I think it is a mistake to go for Jace on turn four in these spots, because it is... I mean, right now it might not look that way, but it is extremely likely that your opponent has a counter spell in their own Jace. Oh, this hand's shaping up nicely. So I think the plan is to Snapcaster opt, then the next turn click end of their turn, and yeah. Because pre-board, you would probably go for it as soon as possible, but after sideboard, there's way more two-mana counterspell. So it is not that unlikely that your opponent just has a negate and a stroke. Like, usually game one, you want to just play the click, and a lot of time they only have one counterspell. You get rid of it, you play your Planeswalker. Wall of Omens. I don't think Wall knows a ton for me right now. It cantrips, but I don't even want to spend the two mana. As long as I'm hitting my land drops, I don't have to go for any plays. So I might just keep playing Drago for a few turns. I have to get rid of that Colonnade now. I don't think there's a reason not to. So game one, you'd be, I think, pretty happy to buff your own wall, but I only have two buffs left after sideboard, and Colonnade can be a problem, so maybe I don't want to go too crazy. I think I'm gonna go for it here. We didn't see Man League game one, did we? I don't think so. Remand. That's fine. I guess I just go for it again next turn. I actually have mana to Teferi plus Logic. Oh no, I only have one. Oh yeah, but I'll have... Yeah, I guess I should go for it. I think there's no reason not to. Was Logic not in the spell? I play the Dispel first, let it go to the grave, and then play my Logic Knot. Oh, okay. Well, their hand must be bad. Maybe full of Planeswalkers. Sometimes you just draw all your Planeswalkers and it's just super awkward. I'm actually not in the greatest spot here. I do have Colonnade, so they go to Teferi minus. I can just finish it off with Colonnade, so using Cryptic there is not that bad. Can I do something a bit better? I don't think so. Really? Not even... Oh, their draw is really bad. They probably have a hand full of Teferi and stuff. Alright, I mean, this game should be pretty much over. Yeah. Just bury them. Don't need that. Don't need that. And a surgical dare cryptic command. Which might have another one. No, it could be one of the clunky cards they have in hand. They might just scoop. Alright, good start. I'm gonna check the audio, hopefully that buzzing noise was gone, and I'll be back for the last rounds. Alright, open and chose to play first, and hand does kind of nothing and have Terminus in my opening hand. I wonder if I would be keeping these hands if that Terminus was a Day of Judgment. This hand doesn't do much either, but kind of does stuff. I think I'm just gonna get rid of elimination here. Humans. Tough matchup. I have four sweepers in my main deck, so got that going for me. I'm gonna up turn one. I only have one Terminus. I'm not sure what you're supposed to do if you have four Terminus in your deck there was opt, if you're supposed to save it. I see if they play a Thalia or something, it's a no-brainer, but I think you're probably supposed to always cast it on turn one there, no matter what, no matter how many Terminus you have in your deck, but somewhat close. So they have a pretty good start. They have the Vial, they have the Cavern, their second land is a Canopy, so they're definitely nicely set up. My hand is also decent so far. They have a freebooter, it's gonna be ugly. Alright, so I don't think they have a 2-drop, because what you want to do if you have a 2-drop there is play Lieutenant and it was a trigger on the stack. You put the 2-drop in play was Vial, because this way Lieutenant gets a counter and the 2-drop you put in play gets a counter. Alright, I'm obviously going to opt first in case I hit the Miracle Terminus. Jace, too slow. And then I'm just going to condemn bigger champion. And I think I should just click them on my turn. Field of Ruin is tempting too for the second white. Mana draw is really awkward here. I think they'd probably not play around Settle though. So actually what I'm gonna do is just go ahead and hit there. Cavern or Horizon Canopy? I'm gonna hit their Cavern. Let's them cast Freebooter. Because I feel like they're gonna... Oh, they had a 2-drop. Oh, and it is a freebooter. So I feel like I kind of got to own here. But I guess they play that well because... Kind of interested now. Well, now I'm gonna get the third blue. It's funny, if they'd wait a tiny bit, I would have gotten white, and I would have gotten wrecked. That's kind of an interesting turn. I didn't expect them to have freebooter, but I guess they decided to. You know, sure, they miss out on a counter on freebooter, but they have the surprise effect, etc., etc. So in hindsight, clicking them was pretty solid play. I'm kind of locked into getting really lucky. I played the click. Got pretty greedy there. Problem is, click is, I was going for the higher upside play, so I still like don't hate my line, honestly. I think it was super reasonable. Don't do that in the upkeep. In their draw step, probably in their draw step. Terminus? Pretty rough. Even if I draw a sweeper, I can't cast it. Wait, four counters? Uh-oh. I'm just dead on board, right? No, but I have very few outs. Am I dead on board now? Still no. All right. This is probably the best matchup for draw a Wall of Omens. Buys you a lot of time. Your sideboarding strat against them is, it's not the greatest. It's like you're not bringing in, like, ideally I would just want more verdicts, more Gear Hulk. I'm not even sure, more condemns and ousts, and I'm reading in like Celestial Purge, Timely, the Second Clay, these kind of like medium-ish cards, but I think it adds up. Stony Silence, I'm not too sure about. I usually don't bring it in, but maybe I should. Let's see, what are some of the bad, the more medium cards? Like Teferi, Jace are not the best. I think I usually board out a Teferi in this matchup. It's how I sideboard. Could bring in Stony Silence, but I don't love it. I used to always bring it in, and I didn't felt like it was super good. And now I don't bring it in, and you're like, man, I wish I had Stony Silence this game, blah, blah, blah. But plus, sometimes they bring in Knight of Autumn, so that's kind of tough. All right, solid hand. The Question is, do I go for cycle elimination or not? I kind of feel like I might be able to just wait till turn four, go like turn two path, turn three snap path, turn four elimination. I see that plan could go wrong if they have Flaudia or Meddling Mage. I think it was four elimination. I'm just supposed to cycle it on turn one. I think I'm just gonna play Polluted Delta for Island. Flak opponents in the tank, they decided to keep. No one drop. That's probably why they were in the tank. There's that theory that says you're not supposed to keep a hand with no one drops when you're playing humans. But obviously you probably wanna, how do you say, you know, case by case. If you have the perfect, you know, freelance, cavern, freebooter, meddling mage, man, I don't know what the perfect humans land. I don't know. Is there a perfect humans hand with no one drop though? It's like pretty sketchy. Lalia does nothing. Oh, it's so nice. Just buys you so much time. Can buy you up to what, two turns maybe? Looks like Gyarok's gonna be worse than an angel this game. We'll see though. I think I might actually wanna just path that. I'm not a big fan of pathing Freebooter, especially with Gearhulk in hand. There's just not that much you can do about the Gearhulk. Could name Meddling Mage next turn, but deny Wrath of God, so that's no good for them. Alright, I'm gonna let them have it and see if I get punished for it. The reasoning being that freebooters like dominoes. They either they get you to the finish line, but if they don't, it's like the domino effect, you know, they one dies, then the next dies, then they get their cards back, and you basically played a card that did nothing. It attacked for one a few turns and then they got their card back. That's nice low insurance. Also, just giving them the extra land is not something I really want to do right now. Do I purge it? It's such a good purge target, but I'm going to take the one, see what happens. I'll probably make them quote-unquote misplay or not knowing that I have the purge in hand. Now they might go like meddling mage on it's, I don't know, what do they even do? They almost need like double meddling mage. Just doing nothing. This is kind of a weird game. I mean, I think this is good for me. I could see Vile being a problem this game. They draw a Vile, then maybe they can actually out-tempo me somehow. Maybe I should just play the Gear Health now. Well, that's a good way of punishing them doing nothing. So if I Jace Brainstorm, they can just Memphis Rider. If I Jace Plus, seems pretty hard for them to do much. I'm gonna put Jace Plus on them, I guess. Gaddock Teeg. I have Gear Hulk, obviously, but it is scary. Like, if they go Meddling Mage on Gear Hulk, Gaddock Teeg, then I can still, like, Purge, Path, etc. But it seems like a bit too good. I'm just gonna get rid of it. Could be a mistake. Seems like they're in a tough spot because they need to get rid of Jace, so they either need to, like, commit a bunch of Mantis Rider and Thalia as attendant, but then they get wrecked by a sweeper. And then if they go for the Meddling Mage approach, blah blah blah, then I just get to start using Jace. I think I'm gonna bring in Stony Silence for game three. We'll see, I'll see. If I see Knight of Autumn, maybe I won't. Just gonna try and get ahead, make sure I don't lose my Jace, make sure I don't get out tempoed. Gearhulk looking juicier and juicier. So I got Purge Mantis Rider and Path Freebooter. I'm just gonna Purge Mantis Rider. Probably just cast Gearhulk next turn. Getting rid of one of the vials sounds kind of good. So they can't just combo me, whatever that is. I could wait one more turn too. I'm gonna just say go one more turn. I could click them there in response. I could do a lot of things. They're probably gonna have like either image or freebooter. Even Snapcaster Purge to freebooter. That feels like pretty. Sometimes I do this thing and where I don't play my cards like too conservatively. Then I end up dying with a bunch of cards in hand and like, well, what went wrong? Why did it all go wrong? So it looks like they have image in hand. Unless they were running the bluff activation. Let's see. I should almost just plus here. Just plus all my planeswalkers. Make sure they don't die to you, Mantis Rider. Deputy of Detention. I click them now. So you need Meddling Mage on Gear Hulk and Gadoktik for Wrath of God or double Meddling Mage. I'm just gonna click them in their draw step actually. Because they need more than one card. They need like multiple good two drops. This way I see their whole hand and... Oh wow, I'm an idiot. Well, they still need multiple good two drops, but yeah, I gave them the one way to get rid of Gearhulk. That's interesting. Oh, they got rid of Wrath of God? Huh. Did not expect that, but I guess I mean if they call me either one. Alright. I think I win. Just a feeling. Let's see, I actually don't want to attack here. I was going to attack, but it's bad because I want to keep Click as my one creature. And they probably don't want to keep Click as their one creature. I mean, this game's got to be 100% over. So you get to keep two because Gearhulk counts as an artifact or a creature. So you can say, all right, I keep Gearhulk as my artifact and Click as my creature. They don't have the luxury. I get a chase back. I've clicked to block a Mantis Rider. I guess my reputation precedes me and they're just not scooping yet. think it was 15 minute plus for the third game, I'll be okay. That'd be impressive even for me. Okay, you're like, fine, you can have it. Alright, I mean, there were a couple spots where I needed to be a bit careful, and maybe I wasn't as careful as I should have been, but overall it was pretty smooth sailing. Probably it's stony sounds on the draw to go turn 2 Thalia, it's like, not before turn 3. And the theory is that when they're on the play, they have one less card, so if they go turn one Vial, they're kind of quote-unquote down a card. But obviously they play 20 lands, so 20 lands with a bunch of Horizons Canopy, so they would definitely make up for it. So I guess I won't bring in Stony Sounds. All right. I think the card I want to see most in my opening hand is just Wall of Omens, but that'll do for now. It's not a bad hand. It's kind of a tricky spot. If it plays Dahlia, I'll probably have to have the champion. I'll add attendant. I think I still have to pay up the champion. Problem is, I want to be able to cast Opt and Cycle Elimination next turn, so. I could wait a turn. Let's see, I could get Island. I mean, getting second one is not bad, especially when I have Cryptic in hand. You know what? I'm just not going to be. Oh, that's a lot of damage, though. But I need to cast my cards. I could just go up, take free. Yeah, maybe that's just better. Alright. Not right now, maybe later. Plus, I give them the land one turn later, which is definitely something. And I get a free shot at Terminus, which is always nice. You always have that out. It's like almost instantly wins you the game. Wow, this is kind of working out nicely for me. And it looks like they're stuck on two lands. Well, maybe not, I guess. All right, the miracle. They do have two Knight of Autumn in their sideboard, but I don't know if they bring them in. And they can't even cast it right now. Feeling a bit desperate. They do get to remove it for Snapcaster Mage, which is nice for them, but Cryptic can take 4. I think I want to snap up though. Actually, I think I need to click them in their draw step. Because I want something that's free power to be able to block champion. Yeah, I like clicking them in their draw step. That Derbent was good. Just exiling one card from my graveyard. That's pretty decent. So their hand's kind of clunky. So it's clunky, but it hits really hard. So if I take Bugler, I risk getting a Rider plus Hierarch, and they attack for, they get in for, I have to block the Mantis Rider, they get in for 6, I go down to 7, and they have a Mantis Rider plus, I guess if they have the land, they don't have another card. What if they play Bugler this turn? Just Bugler. I feel like I should maybe just take Bugler. Bugler or Mantis Rider? How good is the card advantage gonna be? It's close. They just play Bugler, they can't even attack with champion. Bugler might be a bit slow. I'll take a Mantis Rider, I guess. All right, that's kind of unfortunate. Now their champion can be a 4/4. Now they can just play Bugler even. Stack. Because Mantis Rider doesn't make a ton of sense, right? Fallout's Attendant. It's not too scary. Maybe I should just block if I'm gonna go be in Cryptic Command mode. It's gonna save me 4 damage now. I'm just gonna block. I feel like I'm just drawing up the top. I just basically need to find a sweeper. So might as well chump now, because I'm probably gonna be like doing the whole Cryptic Command thing. Not bad at all. It's not even that good though. They get to keep champion and then play a Mantis Rider. It's funny. Might not even cast it next turn. Yeah, I think I'm gonna hold off one turn because it works nicely with my snap. I get to keep snap, I'll have a chum blocker for I can double block the champion it seems much better. But are adding the Mantis Rider to the board. Interesting. Oh yeah, I guess they don't know about Snapcaster. They just want to have Lethal. I have Colonnade too. I guess Colonnade makes kind of things awkward for them. Oh, that's really good for me. They might just have more gas in their graveyard though. And they have a 7/7 champion. Could bounce my detention sphere. Is that better than a card? Tap your creatures, bounce my detention sphere, play Gearhulk, you get to keep Gigantor, Champion of the Parish. How big is it? 11/11. Literally lethal. I think I like drawing better. Tap all creatures you open and control there. All my draws are so good right now. Every card and every spell in my deck's just pretty absurd. Should I cycle first? I mean, if I draw a natural sweeper, that's probably better than Gear Hulk. And I don't think I'm ever gonna have time to. If the cycle could be good, if I go Jace, draw into a Terminus cycle. All right, I'm gonna play Gear Hulk for now. I have a 4/4 Mantis Rider, right? Maybe I messed up. We got rid of one earlier, though. This is pretty scary. Okay, they don't have a second one. That's fairly good for us. That is pretty good in the short term as well. I'm just gonna cycle now. All right, I'm just gonna chase Brainstorm. Oh. Whoops. Accord. So Chase Brainstorm loses if A, I break, B, they have a second Mantis Rider. They need a lot though, they need Mantis Rider. Alright, this is not really a break. So they basically need Mantis Rider plus Freebooter or Mantis Rider plus Thalia, so seems almost impossible. Noble Hierarch. I'm actually gonna use my saddle just for the one creature. Just perfectly happy it was a 4-mana Path to Exile. All right, and now we're at a point where Colonnade kind of takes over, even if I do break. Play it fairly slow. Just attack with Gear Hulk this turn and keep Colonnade back. I'm not sure if Colonnade is more of an upside in this matchup or you usually want like just exactly the one. So having just two in your deck is kind of nice. Because obviously having lands that come into play tapped against a super aggro deck is not the greatest. You could argue that maybe I should just plus from now on. There's maybe a world where I'll lose to the free one that that knocks people. I good enough. There's always that little lag at the end of the games now. I feel like it wasn't like that, but maybe not. Anyways, gonna be playing for the trophy. That's pretty cool. All right, queued up for round five, hopefully the trophy. And I'd like to take a few seconds to remind you to follow Channel Fireball on YouTube if you've enjoyed this video, if you want to see more. If you haven't done so yet, that always helps. Also, if you're looking for any magic cards or magic product, whether it's singles or sealed product, you can shop at Channel Fireball. You can use the promo code YellowHat actually to get 5% off. You can also use that promo code when you register for GPs at Magic Fests. If you need to sell cards, you can sell them at Channel Fireball. And if you want to sell your cards but you plan on buying cards in the future, you can sell them for store credit and you get an extra 30% of value. So really good deal if you want to buy cards now but plan on buying some later. Just in general, if you enjoy the Channel Fireball content, you know, the videos, the articles, definitely consider shopping at Channel Fireball. All right, I figured the round would be up by the time Azan was the little spiel, but should be some queues, should still be some people testing Modern for the Mythic Championship, getting in the queues. We're also at the point where most testing teams are getting together and they're probably really focused on draft right now and limited, since it's pre-release format kind of. The set's not out on Arena yet, it's not out on Magic Online yet. And the only way to test the format is kind of making proxies, cube drafting. In some cases, you make fake packs. So played against Minguchi in round one, but I guess I didn't expect to take that long. Maybe it's also because I'm 4-0, it's trying to pair me against someone who's 4-0, 3-0, 3-1. 1-0, I guess, 2-0. The longer you wait, the loot, the wider the search gets, I guess. It's not uncommon to be 1-0 and get paired against someone who's 4-0, for instance. All right. I usually start the video when I'm in the match, but I figured it'd take a minute or two and then by then we'd have a match and I wouldn't waste any time on the clock. Looks like I was wrong, obviously. The one time I go for it. Anyways, pretty excited. I'm leaving for London tomorrow. I'm gonna meet up with the rest of the team face to face. And hopefully we can somewhat figure out the draft format. We're definitely not gonna have the best limited preparation of the tournament, but hopefully we figure stuff out. And even the other teams, you know, a lot of times when the set comes out early on Magic Online, you know, I'll have done 50 drafts or so. Some people would have done even more than that, like 70 or 100 for those who draft the most. This time around, you know, people are maybe gonna have done like, you know, 15, 20 live drafts. Maybe a bit more. Oh wow, brutal. We join a match and we don't get the pairing. So, my expectations are not super high. It kind of feels bad because I feel like my Modern deck's pretty good. I feel good about it. I think it's strong. I think I play it well. I think I know the matchups fairly well. I still make a lot of mistakes when I play online, but I'm usually streaming and not very focused. By the way, if you do enjoy watching control decks, I do stream daily on Twitch, twitch.tv/yellowhat, all attached. So if you've never checked the stream out, you know, and it's something you think you might like, just you should come and say hi in chat. That'd be cool. And yeah, so it's kind of, in some ways, I feel like it's kind of a shame I didn't, our limited preparation's not going to be super good, but it's just the way it is, I guess. You get to make choices, and it's not super convenient to just leave. I have a wife, so I can't just leave. I'm already gone for a week, which is not great, so if I was gone for longer, I should just lose her mind. All right, looks like we just got the stone longest queue time in the history of Magic Online. All right, first time's the charm, right? Yes. All right, let's see if I can stay focused. So I have Island, Spellstown on the draw opt. All right, this hand looks pretty sweet. And another Grixis Shadow deck. And it's pretty good. Like, you have a low land count, only two lands, which is really good against Grixis Shadow. The downside is I actually don't have a Path to Exile or anything like that, but having your good cards in your opening hand is almost bad in some ways, because they're just going to play a bunch of discard spells in the first few turns. No clue what they're going to take. They could take Up, they could take Wall of Omens, could take Logic Knot, yeah, because I'm pretty likely to be able to cast it on turn two. I might search for Hallowed Fountain. Depends if they play a creature. We'll see. If they play a creature, I might want Hallowed Fountain just in the 2% chance I hit a Terminus up the top. I think it might be worth it. Alright, no Angler. Tough. This matchup's really all about not flooding out. Maybe drawing a card, another card, cycle. I'm actually gonna bottom. And here, I do want to keep Spell Snare up, because a common line for them could be Snapcaster Inquisition. So I'm actually gonna just say go. Play Colonnade and say go here, I think. So I'm still using my mana efficiently no matter what. And I don't expose myself to the Snapcaster play. Probably didn't know about the Spell Snare. Well, that's still, that seems kind of weird to me. They might have a second one in hand. You know about the Spell Snare and you're just letting me use my mana. Like, for them, it almost feels better to, let's see, I'm not in a hurry to get Wall into play. But once again, it would be like fairly mana efficient. All right, I'm not in a hurry to opt either. Just gonna play Wall, see what happens, yeah. Plus, I think they knew I had opt, so they can even like almost wait end of my turn and maybe Snapcast or Thoughtscour. Dismember right away. That means they might have Death Shadow in hand, because I do have a Colonnade in place, so Dismember is somewhat valuable. Death Shadow, they probably have a counter spell. That was an amazing draw. I'm gonna pab them in their upkeep. You know what, actually? No, I was gonna say if I pab them in their upkeep, they can counter, snap counter, but they only have one blue. I don't even have the first counter spell. Snapcaster is kind of my best card. So much better than the other two cards. I'm just going to play the snap and target the opt. And my thoughts is resolve. Targeting the path in case they play a creature is just playing way too scared. You want to get value. If you do that, they're just going to pass. And I don't think that's a good play at all. What a great spot there at five. I mean, they're dead on board if they don't have a removal spell. Simple as that. They do have the Fatal Push. They might have a second one in hand. They're using the first one on... Oh, never mind. I'm just dreaming. I just don't have... It's funny. Just don't have six mana yet. That makes sense. Just gonna say go here. Draw a bunch of cards. Still no pressure. I'm just gonna bottom out something more active, proactive, I guess. I mean, I think I can just go for Fatal Push. It's kind of a weird play. I think if I go for Fatal Push there, it's really hard for them to win. It's Cedar Hand too. I don't think I've ever cast Surgical Extraction on Fatal Push. Is there anything they can still draw? I don't think so. I have one dismember, but then I just killed them the turn after that anyways. Yeah, like two land, five spells, I think, is the sweet spot in this matchup. Followed by three land, four spells in your opening hand. Almost does feel sometimes like it doesn't matter too much which spells it is. Obviously, you don't want all expensive cards, but... Yeah, sideboard out counter spells. I mean, maybe Negate is a bit better now that everyone has Planeswalker. It used to be that sometimes they had one or two, sometimes they didn't have any. I feel like every list has at least two Planeswalkers, sometimes more. Like the Sand Party Stock version, I think, had two Liliana, the Last Hope. But I've seen some versions where it was Last Hope and Lily of the Veil. Some people play one Jace in the sideboard. That's a pretty scary card for a blue-white mage. I'm gonna try to rest in peace again. How did I sideboard last time? I wonder if I can board out a land in the matchup. That's a bit too much. So last time I didn't have any negates and I brought in one rest in peace. And I boarded out a Cryptic Command, I think. Which is a bit questionable. I could maybe do a Cryptic Command and a land. Can I go down to 20 free lands on the draw? I don't think so. You still need 2 of your land drops. Alright, I'm going to keep doing the one rest in peace. Even though I'm not a fan of it, especially on the draw. Alright, pretty solid hand. As I said, it doesn't really matter which spells you have, you just want the right mix, because they're gonna get hit by discard spells, etc., etc. You just want to have a hand that makes you less likely to flood. Ooh, basic Ellen, that's good for us. Now if they could Thoughts Cower their basic swamp, I'd greatly appreciate that. That'd be kind of amazing. No. Damn it. Targeting themselves. What about the first one? Targeting themselves too, so they don't know about my purge in hand. Steam vent? Weird. Really weird. Do I path now and give them the land right away, and I'll have purge next turn? Or I guess they get to loot once if I do it in their upkeep. Alright, I'll just path it now. It's not great, it's kind of scary, but oh well. Jace would be good beats here. Possible Cryptic is too clunky and they should just be negates, but I do feel like you get the value sometimes. Another Jace. Don't mind that. My path is free now. Looks like an Angler the way they're tapping their mana. Okay. This is great for me. This is working out very nicely. Good snap path, just to not getting them out double black seems really good. Are they gonna have the basic mountain as well? The new technology? No. Feels good. Just moss acid. A field of ruin that turned into moss acid, basically. Super strip mine. Alright, that's a pretty solid turn for them. Good value. Still anyone's game. Skip one on top. That's a good draw. Assuming they're gonna use Stubborn Denial if they have it. I don't think I'm super in a rush here. Let's see, what are my options? Leave Cryptic up. It's nice that I have the extra mana now, so they can't go Spell plus Stubborn Denial. I could play the wall now. And they have Snap Path to Exile up. I think I like just saying go one more turn. Even if they play something like a Serum Visions, I can just Cryptic. Just get the 2-for-1. They're a bit flooded. They don't play a ton of lands and they have a lot of fetch land, but I feel like Grixis Shadow is just a deck that floods a lot just because you have so many cantrips. I'm gonna search first, just one less land in my deck. Let's get Island. Alright, so you can't get Hallowed Fountain because I don't want to get Stubborn Denialed. I'm not going to use it. I wonder if people notice that. Probably they're paying attention. It's not a matchup where getting low matters too much. Alright, should I try and cut them off? I guess I'll go after blue and black mana. It's a good one. Huh. Rest in peace. Funny. 4, 6, 7. I'm gonna place untap land. This way I have Snap plus Cryptic to play around Stubborn Denial. Same deal. If they don't do anything, I'll just Snap Elimination and they can Stubborn Denial it. Almost every last place is in full stroke now, one or two. I'm at 8. They're at 8. I guess I'll attack. Not the most impressive rest in peace. Definitely wish it was something like a negate. Geist has been pretty good. I wonder if I'm gonna end up playing that card in the Mythic Championship. I think I might. Shaheen has been really high on it. Alright, so I'll lose like Battle Rage, Bolt. The fact that they're attacking is kind of terrifying, honestly. They don't even play Bolt in their deck anymore. I don't even know what they would need to have. Like the list, they don't play Bolt. They play maybe one. Do we need to have Bolt, Snap, Bolt? No, I have Rest in Peace. Yeah, I think they're just trying to get me to block. It's gonna be funny if I lose this game. So I didn't block. When I have Colonnade Terminus, Purged Attention Sphere. Probably should have not attacked with Snapcaster Mage. I just don't see a combination of cards I lose to. They just don't play Bulbs. Or not more than one. Alright. The Bad Manor Click, I guess. Nothing wrong with playing a little safe. I guess they could have Dismember plus Snapcaster to go block, kill Colonnade. No, it is still Light to the Angel. Alright, well, that's good just before the Mythic Championship. Get all 5-0 in. Never hurts. So what was it? Swear Prison, couple of Grixis Shadow deck. I've already forgotten. Oh, Humans. And Max Dog was playing. Was it Shadow as well? I feel like I played maybe 3 times against Grixis Death Shadow. I expect Grixis Shadow to be one of the most played decks. But yeah, we'll see. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you next time. Yeah, take care.